Today, Adobe updated Photoshop to version 2024. Now, this is the day a lot of people have been waiting for because some of the features that were in beta are now in the main Photoshop. I'm going to let you know the new features in this overview video, and I'm also going to answer some of the questions you may have along the way. So let's jump in. So the first feature I want to mention is this taskbar at the bottom. Yes, it's not new, but something that you've been wanting is. So say, for example, I'm here and I go to make a selection. This taskbar jumps around. People find that super annoying. But you can jump over here and you can choose to pin the bar position. And then you can just drag it wherever you want. And now when I make selections, do different things, the bar is not moving. Now, one of the big problems with this is whenever you relaunched Photoshop, it relaunched the behavior. And I'm happy to let you know that this now stays persistent. So wherever you leave this bar, it's going to stay there even the next time you launch Photoshop. Yay! And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. And whenever I do a new feature video, people are like, I don't see this feature in my Photoshop. So what you need to do is update Photoshop by going up to the Creative Cloud. That would be at the bottom if you're on Windows. Then go under Updates. Before you do anything, this is where a lot of people miss it, is choose Check for Updates. Now it's going to hit the server, and if it hadn't appeared in your panel, it's going to find it and it's going to add it to your panel. Then you go under New Updates and you would see one there for Photoshop. But I already updated today, as you can see. In your case, you would hit Update, Relaunch, and then you've got the new Photoshop. So big news, Generative Fill AI is now in Photoshop. So if I make a selection here, say around this camera, I can choose Generative Fill. I can click on it, and this gives me the option to tell it what I want to put in there. So let's put in hairdryer. And then just choose Generate. Now, what is new here is we've got these tips. So each time you do generate a fill, you're going to see these new tips, as well, of course, it being here inside of Photoshop and not beta. All right, so there we go. We've got a hairdryer, and we could choose different versions under Variations. You're going to see we've got different versions that we can click on. The other thing is we now have, let me just drag this out. The other thing we now have is larger thumbnail previews if we click on there, and we can see these previews are indeed larger. If you want to generate three more, just click Generate one more time. And as you can see, now we have six different options here, or we can make those smaller. And now that Generative Fill is out of beta and in Photoshop, it's approved for commercial work. All the AI training has come from Adobe stock, so it's all licensed work at Adobe, so it's not just going across the internet and grabbing images without people's permission for training this AI. So there's three main things you'll use Generative Fill for. One is to replace an object, which we've already done. We can use it to expand. So let's zoom out. We're going to grab our crop tool, and we can drag this out to the side. And we could type in what we want to put there. And if you just wanted to expand the existing photo, just choose Generate. And based on the pixels and what it can see there, it's going to expand that. A question I'm going to get, is this high resolution yet? The answer is no, it's not. It still generates in 1024 by 1024 blocks. So if we zoom in here, we can see the original image is very sharp. On the edges there is a lower resolution. I've done another tutorial where I show you how to kind of hack that and create an action to build it in smaller squares. Check that out on my playlist. So another one is Generative Expand. I'm going through these quickly because I've covered these in other tutorials, but let's hit the Expand here and say I wanted to change the aspect ratio to a 1x1 square. We want to make that larger. Let's pop that in the middle. And then we just hit Generate. And this is basically the same thing as outcropping. If I just crop it larger, it does the same thing, but Generative Expand gives you a few more options. Check out the dedicated video I've done on that where I can show you to do it to a specific size or aspect ratio. And the third behavior of Generative Fill is just basically to remove an object. So let me just do this. We'll take the lasso tool. We'll go around there. And I'll hit Generative Fill without putting any content in there and just hit Generate. And as you can see, it removes the object, analyzes the background, and creates something that should go in there to fit it. And if you look at that, it's pretty good. The shadow, oh, okay, no problem. We just do the same thing again. And voila, looks perfect. And speaking of generative fill, I created an entire course on it. Check out underneath for a code where you can get a discount off it. The next new tool we're going to look at, which has brand new functionality, is the remove tool. So some of you may know, with the remove tool, you brush over the area you want to get rid of. And it does a pretty amazing job. Now, a tip, a good way to use this is to create a new layer. And we want to turn on sample all layers. So here's a brand new functionality. It's kind of like the Pixel phone when you have the magic eraser. What we're going to do is just make a circle around the area you want to get rid of. Release it. It knows the area. It selects it. And look at that. It automatically gets rid of it for you. So let's get rid of the shadow. Yeah, sometimes the results are a little unpredictable. If that's the case, undo it. And then we're just going to do it the slow way, one bit at a time. There we go. Another useful feature are the new gradient tools. So why don't I just add a LUT here and we'll use it on a mask. So I'm going to choose color lookup. We'll click on the LUT and we're going to choose moonlight. So let's light that up. Black for the foreground color. Go up under the gradient tool. Choose black to transparent or black to white. Either one will work. Let's do black to white. We're going to use a radial gradient. And make sure we're in normal mode, opacity 100. So if I drag this out, notice that we can create a spotlight that we can move around. Now I did a tutorial recently where I showed you this in beta, but now it's in the main one. If you grab this dot, we can change the shape of this. And of course, you know, we can grab it and rotate it. And just kind of create the spotlight effect. Now, if you're worried about it going over the top, we can definitely fix that. All we need to do is just grab our selection tool, drag it across the top here, and in that mask, I would just fill it with white. A command delete on the Mac fills with the background color. But when you use another tool and you go back into the mask and you grab the gradient, notice it's still applied. So that hasn't changed. That behavior is still the same as it was before. So as far as these masks being re-editable, they're not. If I want to add a second gradient, what I'm going to do is make sure I use the black to transparent rather than the black to white. And this way you can add additional gradients without affecting the gradients that you've applied before. If you do black to white, it would just reset this mask. Notice that the transparency, it will keep the other part of the mask so you can add multiple light sources just kind of working that way. If we're on that mask, and I choose a gradient tool, notice it appears again. But if I apply another tool, let's clean up the top of this, fill it with white. When I go back in here, notice it doesn't select that mask again. Last feature I want to mention is the preset sync. You know the one that never worked before? Yeah, it's gone. They removed it. So if you lost your presets because of it, I'm sorry. Maybe I'll do a video on how to back up presets and stuff. If you want something like that, let me know in the comments underneath. So let me know in the comments underneath what was your favorite new feature. And check out my other videos where I go into all these features in more depth. If you're new to the cafe, welcome. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.